in the same way in the class to millions of students, and every night millions of students sit over the exact same homework trying to figure out how to solve it. Now friends, take 1 minute and write on a piece of paper your frustration over this kind of mode of delivering the lecture. Yes, take 1 minute only. So identify frustration you have in your teaching or with your students learning. Let me give you a hint. Frustration is in regard to students not taking interest in the class. They are unattentive. They don't submit homework or assignment on time. Whenever you ask question, either the students do not respond to the question, or only one or two students get the opportunity to answer question. So the teacher cannot, ask question every student. Teacher cannot engage every student in the classroom. Teacher wants to give some demo, but because of paucity of time or the workload, or you can say the syllabus, so he just delivers lecture in the classroom. So any other if you have noticed, if you have written, please share in the chat box. Yes. I think agree with me in regard to the frustration. So if I could fix one thing in my class, it would be very effective, or effective learning will take place on the part of learners. So what are some of the needs that you identified? We can break down into four common findings. One is student motivation in the classroom. This is another, major, I think, problem, because every teacher discusses what can I do to motivate my students to learn. Okay, so motivation of student is very much essential, because will help you to gain the attention of the student, and they will take interest in the classroom. They will respond to your question quickly. They will submit assignment on time. So what is there, what should be there in the classroom so that the student can be motivated? Likewise, unique instructional capabilities, that the teacher possesses many things, but because of the huge content in the syllabus, he just employ the lecture method. Support for new instructional approaches, increased teacher productivity. Now let us discuss all these. Student motivation. I need to capture the interest of my students, but I'm not able to do it. I want students to have a greater sense of control over their learning. Again, this is not possible in case of lecture mode of imparting instruction, because when you are delivering a lecture, sometimes your rate of delivery is very fast, and there are slow learners. They are not able to understand. My students are not prepared for class discussion because they haven't kept up with the textbook reading. So I'm just dictating something from my notes to the students. I'm just pouring the information, and the student says, sir, why should I come to your class? Because you are simply dictating something from a particular book. What is new in your class? You have not integrated media. Okay, you have not captured our interest, our attention. This is the main problem in regard to student motivation. In regard to unique instructional capabilities, I need to be able to demonstrate processes. But the PPT or the video, I have not got it. My students need access to extra resources to update or expand on what the text offers. So the teacher is not providing any links for, you see, supplementary material. You see, there are large number of videos available on the YouTube, and the text is also available on Google. So what the teacher has to do, he has to, you see, identify the relevant material, and the link must be passed on to the students. I would like the students to track their progress in the course. It is not happening in the traditional classroom teaching because only 1 or 2% are asked. This is possible if the self-learning material is provided to the students in the form of module or computer assisted instruction package, and that is given to the student to study at home, and when they come to the class, actual problem solving is carried out. Only then the student will be able to track their progress in the course. My students need to be able to assess their understanding of the content. I would like to provide students with more immediate feedback of their work. This is again not possible in traditional classroom teaching because only 1 or 2 questions are asked. Only 1 or 2 students are allowed to answer the question, or some, many a times only the same student is asking, responding this the question. My students need to spend more time on task practicing a skill. Again, it is not possible because I am simply providing theoretical knowledge to the students, and I hardly give some time for doing the things in the classroom. Support for new instructional approaches. I would like to reduce the amount of time spent in class on lecturing without sacrificing coverage of the content. Dear friend, this is possible only if the teacher has prepared the self-learning material. He has either selected some video from YouTube, or he has himself recorded some video, and the material is provided to the student to study at home. And when they come to the class, the you can say the more time can be given for discussion in the classroom or for solving problems in the classroom. My students need opportunities for continuing discussion for peer learning. This is not possible in traditional classroom teaching. I would like to help my students focus more on understanding and application rather than only what will this be on the test, that is on the remembering part. You see, Bloom has given the taxonomy, and under cognitive domain, 6 learning outcomes have been identified, beginning with the remembering part, moving to this understanding, applying, analyzing, evaluating, and creating. And in the classroom, teacher gives emphasis only on the remembering part. I would like to give my students a great sense of responsibility for their learning. So this is possible if they are given opportunity for independent learning. Increase teacher productivity. I would like to do more activity-based learning in class, but I have a lot of material I need to cover. I would like students to have more frequent grade updates. Okay, so in what category would you put your need? Definitely, you see, faculty are encouraged to move from a teaching model to a learning model, but how do you do that in your class? How do you, as a faculty member at an institution that emphasizes teaching, move from the sage on the stage? Who is the sage? The person who has got the expertise, who has got the knowledge that has come with the, you see, experience, to the guide on the side. So teaching model, you see, brings teacher, acts, enables teacher to act as a stage, act as a sage on the stage. But in the learning model, okay, the teacher has to guide the students, and he has to guide on their side. Now you see, the flipped classroom is turning this upside down. Friends, you see, we are living in a time when things are moving fast, the rules of game are changing, science is changing, technology is changing, the world of work has also changed, but our students are, for the most part, still constrained by the conventional transmission model of learning. Friends, you know that today's students grew up with internet access, YouTube, Facebook, MySpace and a number of other digital resources. I think Dr. S.S. Patnaik, in his session yesterday, made a mention of number of other technologies during his session on socio-digital pedagogy. The students can typically be found doing their homework while texting their friends, iming on Facebook, and even listening to music all at the same time. So the use of the traditional learning approach, which focuses on the teacher as the center of knowledge, is irrelevant in today's digital age. So as a solution, teaching learning traditional classroom activities like lectures, laboratory homework, and exams can be moved to the Web 2.0 technology, and students, you see, can study everywhere outside the classroom. That is, if the teacher has developed self-learning material, and that self-learning material the teacher has uploaded in the website of the institute, the students can, you see, download the material, they can study at home, and even the self-learning material will be helpful to those students who were absent in the yesterday's class. They can download and they can, you see, study the material. Friends, let me inform you that I have developed a massive open online course on development of self-learning material. And this massive open online course is available on SWEM platform of Government of India. And its last date is still there. That is 28th February is the last date. Already it has started, but the last date is 28th February. It will help you to develop self-learning material, maybe the printed e-content material or the computer-assisted instruction. I'll give you the illustration of computer-assisted instruction in my lecture today. So please, you can register for this course, and this is an AICTE-approved faculty development program, and it is of 2 credit, and the certificate will be issued by Ministry of Education, Government of India. So friends, the flipped classroom, because of the net generation that is highly devised, highly networked, highly interactive, and highly social. Okay, so for this, for such type of net generation students, traditional approach is not relevant in today's context. We have to employ some other mode of delivering instruction. I have taken one research study from the internet, and they have surveyed 8 to 18 years old kids, and they say that 6.21 hours the kids spend with media per day. 26% of the time, kids use more than two media simultaneously. Okay, they spend 3.5 hour on TV video per day, 1.44 hour on music per day, 1 hour approximately using computer other than for school or college work, 49 minutes playing video games, 43 minutes of recreational reading, and so on. So the students, to them, computers are not technology. They are interested in multitasking. They are involving in doing, they are doing many things at a time. Reality is more and more a meaningless term nowadays. And friends, all of us know about successful learning. Successful learning involves the student to remain active. So once the students are provided the self-learning material, they will study at their own pace, they will remain active, and they are also provided with immediate knowledge of result, because self-learning material contains inbuilt questions followed by feedback also. I'll give you the illustration. So students want to remain active in the classroom, and this is possible only if the teacher is not giving the lecture in the classroom, but he is involving them in solving problem or giving the problem to a small group of two, three students. So they work in a team. So contextual. Successful learning takes place only if the teacher relates the content matter with examples from the students' daily life or examples from the world of work. So successful learning is the result of the association of new learning with already known things. Successful learning take place when the students are engaged, they are involved, they are participating. Okay, so active participation on the part of student is possible only if the teacher is not delivering lecture in the classroom, and rather he is you see helping students solve homework or home assignment or some problems or some project. Successful learning takes place when the students interact with the teacher, or when the student interact with other students in the classroom. Only then the fundamentals are clear. And successful learning takes place only once the students, they work in small groups, social, because their social need is very important. Let us have a look at the learning pyramid. Okay, you see, we tend to comprehend 10% of what we read, isn't it? 20% of what we hear, and 30% of what we see. So reading, hearing words, when we are 30% of what we see means when we look at pictures, watch a movie, look at an exhibit. Okay, so the teacher is showing PPT, or he is drawing some sketch on the chalkboard, or teacher has shown the video in the classroom. Okay, so 50% of what we both hear and see, that is watching a demonstration, because during a demonstration, teacher is explaining the process, seeing it done on location. That is, say, when the students are taken to actual site for, say, explaining the parts of, say, transformer or some other, you can say, big machinery which cannot be brought into the classroom. And 70% of what we say, that is, when we participate in discussion, gives a talk or doing some dramatic presentation, and 90% of what we both say and do, that is simulating a real experience, doing the real things. Okay, so to address these needs, we try to open up class time for active learning strategies. But how do I do that and still provide the same coverage of the content? This is what we mean by the classroom flipped model. So the flipped classroom is turning the problems of traditional classroom upside down. You know, traditionally, students listen to lectures and take tests in class, read textbooks, and work on problems set at home. But in the flipped teaching, students first study the topic by themselves using video lessons on YouTube, and then apply the knowledge by solving problems and doing practical work in the classroom. And friends, many good institutions have started using flipped model in the classroom, because they say the flipped model benefits the student and the teacher in number of ways. Firstly, flipped classroom allows all students to learn at their own pace, as the e-content can be studied again and again, or the videos can be watched again and again. That is, the teacher has to prepare the e-content, or he has to record the video, and if it is not possible, then he has to identify the video available on YouTube. He has to provide the link to the students. Now the material is given to the student in advance. They will study at home, okay? And when they come to the classroom with the content knowledge, then they can participate actively in the you can say discussion. So it's more efficient as students enter the classroom prepared to contribute. Flipped classroom enriches the lesson, as more time can be spent on group work or project work, and doing, you see, homework in class allows students to help each other, which benefits both the above average students and you can say less average, below average students. above average and below average. So a flipped classroom is an instructional strategy and a type of blended learning which is focused on student engagement and active learning, giving the teacher a good opportunity to deal with mixed levels, student difficulties, differentiated learning preferences during in-class time. I have talked to you about differentiated instruction yesterday, and you know there are wide individual differences among learners in regard to their age, their intelligence, their you see personality, their learning style, and so on. So the flipped classroom, you see, has been highlighted as an emergent technology. This is known as a student-centered approach to learning, where students are more active than the teacher in the classroom activity. So in this case, teacher acts as a facilitator to motivate, to guide, to give feedback on students' performance. So what does it mean to flip? What is typically presented in class, that is lectures, content, background knowledge, or real life experiences by a live teacher, now students receive at home via reading material, maybe e-content, self-learning material, computer assisted instruction, YouTube video, or other online resources. So effort on the part of teacher is to develop e-content or record video or to identify the relevant content, relevant, that is content relevant to the particular topic. So he can identify the supplementary material from the Google. Lot of material is available. Many videos are available. You type any topic on the YouTube search, you will find many videos ranging from 2 minutes to 1 hour or 1.5 hour. So the effort on the part of teacher is to you see identify such material and to provide to the student. And let me make a mention here that one of my student has studied the effect of WebQuest instruction on achievement of student, and this is nothing but WebQuest only. So what is typically given as homework is done in class with the assistance of the teacher. This is flipped learning. Now flipped classroom has got many educational implications of pedagogical theories, or you can say flipped classroom is based upon the educational implications of pedagogical theories. And Allen, an educationist, he has looked at various pedagogical theories and tried to examine their applications to the flipped classroom. And these theorists include Weocroxy, Bloom, Keller, and Skinner. And Allen has given a concise introduction to each theorist fundamentals, and he has tried to apply to flipped classroom. So let us have a look at these theorists briefly. Firstly, it is Lev Vygotsky, who was a Russian development psychologist and proposed a theory of development of higher cognitive functions in students that saw reasoning as emerging through practical activity in a social environment. His theories emphasize that students can reach a higher level of understanding through group work, which is a key component of flipped classroom. Whereas lectures emphasize conformity and memorization only, group work emphasizes problem solving and application of knowledge. So he has talked about, you see, group work. Another educationist, Bloom, an American educational psychologist, he contributed to the theory of mastery learning model. This theory stated that student must master prerequisite material before moving on to learn subsequent information. So the focus of teaching should be on the time required for individual student to master any given information. As such, students should receive individualized instruction in the form of self-learning material. They will study at home, they will work at their own pace, and receive regular formative assessment from the material. So these are all the characteristics of the flipped classroom model. Another theorist, Fred Keller, an American experimental psychologist, he developed the personal system of instruction, which has given focus for mastery learning. He developed the Keller plan, the component of which consisted of unit mastery, that is essentially chunking long lectures or content into discrete units. You see self-learning material or CEI packages, you see contain material which is presented in small steps. So student learn the first input, then they answer the inbuilt questions or practice task questions, and they also come to know about the knowledge of their result immediately, because feedback is also given. Okay, so these are the characteristics of the. Then you see another is B.F. Skinner, an American psychologist and behaviorist, who developed, you see, theories of reinforcement and radical behaviorism. So in terms of educational theory, reinforcement, you see, was applied to sequential learning, as students had to master a concept before moving to the next one with prompt feedback. You see, in the traditional classroom teaching, the teacher, you see, ask question, the student responds to the question, and the teacher says, wonderful, you have said very rightly, but this is only in case of one or two students. But if the content is given to them in the form of self-learning material, and each material contains input in small units and followed by inbuilt question and feedback, then they feel very happy. So this is applicable to flipped classroom, as in class activities allow for a chance at immediate assessment of applied knowledge, because they have studied at home and now they are applying to the problems for solving the problems, and they get immediate feedback from their teacher. So a flipped classroom is one that inverts the typical cycle of content acquisition and application, so that students gain necessary knowledge through e-content or self-learning material or computer-assisted instruction, videos, etc. before class, and teachers guide students to actively and interactively clarify and apply that knowledge during class. Friends, let me give you one suggestion. Please do a small experiment. Identify any five topics from your area of specialization and prepare e-content for those five topics, or develop video or identify video from YouTube. Also develop one small question paper containing items pertaining to these five topics. Now select a group of 50 students, divide that group into two subgroups randomly. One group can be called as an experimental group, another group will be a control group. Now both the groups will be given the test that you have developed as a pre-test in order to know their previous score. Then give exposure to one group through flipped classroom, that is during that you see flipped classroom, you are not teaching the content in the classroom, you are providing the material to the student to study at home, and when they come to the classroom, problem solving exercises will be taken out taken to the other group. You will be teaching the same content by the traditional method, and after 5 days this experiment is over, again administer the same test to know their post test score. Now you can compute significant of difference between means of two groups, and you will yourself find out that the students who were exposed through flipped classroom teaching obtained higher scores than the students who were taught by merely chalk and talk method. And lot of literature is available, number of studies are available in the internet, and they have found that the flipped classroom will help students attain higher scores. So a flipped classroom intentionally shifts instruction to a learner-centered model in which time in classroom is used to explore topics in greater depth and create meaningful learning opportunities, while students are initially introduced to new topics outside of the class, that is home. So content delivery may take a variety of forms, like video lessons prepared by the teacher or prepared by third parties, and online collaborative discussion, digital research, text reading, etc. Let us learn the definition of some of the educationists. Flipped classroom is that which is traditionally something that which is traditionally done in class is now done at home, and that which is traditionally done as homework is now completed in the class. This is flipped classroom. Flipping the classroom involves pushing lecture material outside the classroom as a form of homework or other pre-class preparation, leaving more time in class for interaction or for engaging them in exercises. Set of pedagogical approaches that move most information transmission teaching out of class, using class time for learning activities that are active and social, and require students to complete pre and post class activities to fully benefit from the in-class work. I think the concept is clear to you. Before class, the old model is the students are assigned something to read in the classroom, okay? And now in the new model, students are guided through learning module that ask and collects questions. In the old model, students try to follow along, whereas in the new model, students practice performing the skills they are expected to learn. Now during the classroom, teacher tries to get through all the material, and students attempt the homework usually with the delayed feedback. Okay. And in the new model, the teacher guides the process with feedback and mini lectures. That is, he can supplement. You have given the material in the to the student to study at home, and if they have got any doubt, they want to seek further information or you see clarification, teacher can provide clarification, supplement information, more examples during the class. Okay. Office hours. Students want confirmation about what to study. Okay. So teacher often repeats what was in lecture. Office hour is with every teacher, because he takes 3 to 4 lecture, and rest of the time he is available in his chamber. And in the new model, students are equipped to seek help where they know they need it, and teacher continues guiding students toward deeper understanding. So flipped teaching or flipped classroom, it is a form of blended learning in which you see students learn new content through reading material, self-learning material, computer assisted instruction, or online by watching video lecture, usually at home. And what used to be the homework, that is you assign some exercises, problem, is now done in class, with teacher offering more personalized guidance and interaction with the student instead of lecturing. And some educationists say that it is backward classroom or reverse instruction, or flipping the classroom, or it is also called as reverse teaching. So a traditional pattern of teaching is to assign students to read textbooks and work on problems. In flipped teaching, the student first study the topic by themselves, typically using video lessons, reading material prepared by the teacher. In class, students apply the knowledge by solving problems and doing practical work. So I can relate flipped classroom with Bloom's taxonomy. You see, Bloom's taxonomy at the lower level, it is the remembering. Then comes understanding, applying, analyzing, evaluating, and creating. So before class, the material is available with them. So they are simply remembering it. So remembering and to some extent understanding is involved before coming to the class. That is, the students are provided with e-content. And you see, if e-content is developed on a conversational mode, that is, the content is written in an interactive language. मैं भी आपको example दूंगा, आपको मैं एक illustration दूंगा कि कैसे मैंने interactive language use किया है. Then when the student is reading it, he will think that the teacher is talking to me and not he is simply reading the text from a textbook. So this is different from textbook. So they will be able to understand many things after reading the e-content. And during the class, whatever they have learned, whatever they have understood, that is applied there and that is analyzed. And after the class, students are given some project work where in the evaluating and creating learning outcomes can be achieved. So flipped classroom is not, you see, just online videos that you have given them the links and you have asked them to study themselves. This is not just online videos, not just reading or learning material. अपना जो है वो हमने जो है उनको material दे दिया, now our responsibility is over. This is not flipped classroom. Flipped classroom is not about replacing teacher with video reading material or learning material. It is not an online class. It is not students working without structure. It is not students working in isolation. It is not students spending the entire class online. And what is flipped classroom? It is a means to increase teacher contact time, an environment that increases student responsibility. Flipped classroom is blending of instruction and constructivist learning. A class where all students are engaged. It is a class where absent students won't fall behind because material is with them. Okay, classroom mein to sirf exercises hongi na, to material to ghar mein unko de diya, they have got the material. Kai baar to bachchon ke paas material nahi thi. Teacher jo classroom mein kya karta hai, he is simply giving them dictation. Ek book le liya, usme se unko dictate kar diya. And it is class where all students are involved in their learning. They are engaged in their learning. So traditional teaching, isolated students, single source of information, one way flow of information, limited class time, receivers of information only. Blended instruction, students are connected, they learn at their own pace, their participation has increased, and the strong sense of community because the content can be related with the can be related by giving some community based projects, peer modeling, and they are also producing information. So now let us have a look at the advantages of you see flipped classroom over traditional method of teaching and learning. Firstly, flipped model teaches students to take responsibility for their own learning. How? You see, with the flipped model, the responsibility for learning is placed squarely on the students. So in order to succeed, the student must take responsibility for his or her own learning. That is, he has to study at home. Kai baar hum kahenge ki how we can ensure that the students have studied the material at home. if he or she has not studied the material, he or she will not be able to participate in the classroom exercises. So as the teacher gives up control of the learning process, the student takes the reins and the education process becomes their own. Secondly, the mastery model creates a way to easily personalize and differentiate the classroom. You see, flipped classroom allows the direct instruction to be asynchronous. Asynchronous communication is one which you see does not need clock signal between the sender and the receiver. And in asynchronous communication, the data transfer rate is very slower. Okay. So differentiation for each student becomes possible because they can study at their own pace. The pace of class is appropriate for each student, and this personalizes the learning for each student. Another advantage is that the flipped model makes learning the center of the classroom. So flipped classes, you see, have become laboratories of learning where the entire focus of the class is on what students have or have not learned. So the teacher provides them with the material to learn and support them by helping them develop a plan for how and when they will learn. And the rest is up to the student. It gives students instant feedback and reduces teachers' paperwork. Okay. Another advantage is that it provides opportunity for remediation. You see, in the traditional classroom, the class moves on with or without students who do not understand. The pace of class is set by the teacher, and it is based upon the material that is to be delivered on a particular day. So under this conventional model, some students get further behind, their grades suffer, and they are penalized for being slower. But flipped classroom model does not penalize slower students. Instead, the teacher give them ample opportunities to relearn and remediate. So built into the immediate feedback is time for teachers to work with students and catch any doubts or misunderstanding or misconceptions. Flipped model allows for multiple means of learning the content. Okay. You see, we are providing videos, assignment, and we can also provide them the support. You can say references from the internet or the YouTube video links. It provides multiple chances for demonstrating understanding through summative small tests which are built into the self-learning material. You can hold verbal discussion in the classroom. You can also provide them supplementary PowerPoint presentation, short videos can be given to the, or you can give the demonstration for understanding something written in say text. Another is that the mastery model has changed the role of the teacher. So instead of standing in front of the class, pouring the information and being the center of attention, the teacher now spends time doing what is most important, that is helping the student, leading small groups, and working with individual who is struggling. Okay, this is the role of the teacher now. Another is that flipped model ensures that all students are engaged, all students are involved. So all students are in charge of their own learning. Traditionally, a teacher standing in front of students, probably with a PowerPoint presentation, maybe even on an interactive whiteboard, is simply talking to the students. So a flipped mastery classroom looks significantly different. Now students are engaged in a variety of activities like taking assignments, watching a video, discussing a topic with the teacher, engaging in hands-on activities, working in small group, and so on. The mastery model makes hands-on activities more personal. You see, hands-on activities help students learn in a way other than direct instruction. So before flipped mastery, we would conduct these hands-on activities in a large group. The whole class would receive instruction on the experiment, and all of the students would conduct the activities simultaneously. Because the flipped mastery is asynchronous, so students conduct the experiments when they feel they are ready to do so. So the time varies from one student to another student. Now, benefits of flipped classroom to the students and the teachers. Students can learn at their own pace. They are provided opportunities for review because content is given to them. Materials are ready. It is also helpful for absentees. Take ownership of their learning, actively work with their peers, and do not struggle with completing the homework because homework is done in the classroom. It is beneficial to the teachers in the sense that now the focus is shifted from sage on the stage to guide on the side. The teachers spend more time for supplementing with practice, spend less time managing student classroom behavior problem, collaborative with peers, connect with students, involved with student learning rather than presenting only the lecture. So role of the teacher in the context of flipped classroom. As I told you just now that the flipped classroom has changed the role of the teacher. So in order to function as an effective teacher in the flipped classroom environment, a few of the characteristics on the part of teacher are very essential. Firstly, the teacher should be a content master. You see, a teacher who is not proficient in his content area cannot operate in a flipped mastery class. So the teacher's ability to move from one topic to another is very essential. And a comprehensive understanding of the interconnectedness of the content is very essential. So teacher has to prepare for the topic very well, because there could be number of questions from the students. So in case some question comes to the student, how the teacher is going to handle this question if the answer is not known to him? So what he can do, he can address the same question to all the students. Okay, maybe some hint, maybe some student answer the question and you get some hint, you can elaborate upon it. In case you don't get any answer, what you can do is you can simply say and admit that right now I don't know its answer. I'll study at home. You also study at home. So tomorrow we will take up this question. And when you go to class next day, your first responsibility is to take up the question. But this should not happen every day. Aaj fir ek question aaya, mere paas answer nahi hai. Maine bola aaj main ghar jaake padhunga, kal bhi padhunga, bacche bhi padhenge. So agar roz aisa hota hai, then we will lose the confidence of our students. Another is the teacher must be able to admit when he or she doesn't know the answer. Abhi maine bola to student question, and must be willing to research an answer with the student. The teacher must be able to flow through a class period in a non-linear fashion. You see, all the students are at different places in their mastery, that you know, an understanding of the learning objective. So it is the role of the teacher to meet each student where he or she is. The teacher must be able to give up control of the learning process to the students. And the teacher needs to play the role of a supportive coach. Teachers are here to encourage these students along the road of learning, because students need a coach who can come alongside them and guide them in the discovery of knowledge. And teachers tell the students what they are doing right to clarify their misconceptions. So to conclude, I would say that flipped classroom model has helped teachers doing what is most important, that is helping students, leading small groups, and working with individuals who are struggling. So let me provide you the list of, you see, findings of some of the research studies. A most recent systematic view, which was carried out in 2017, these three persons, they have examined 46 papers available on the internet about the effectiveness of flipped classroom in medical education with different learning outcomes. And they have reported the findings in respect of the effect of flipped classroom, perceptions of flipped classroom, attitude changes after using the flipped classroom, knowledge, skills, and behavior changes with the flipped classroom. So in regard to effect of flipped classroom, the review suggested here inconsistent findings regarding the effect, with some suggesting benefits while others reporting negligible improvement over traditional teaching method. Of course, they have got benefit, okay? In regard to perceptions of flipped classroom, students were generally satisfied with the approach, particularly the usefulness of online content, videos, modules, because of easy access to resources for self-paced learning. And in regard to attitude changes, positive changes were reported in this review study, and studies have suggested that medical students reported increased enjoyment, decreased boredom, and greater task value in flipped classroom. And knowledge, skills, and behavior changes, mixed results were detected regarding students' changes in knowledge and skills with the flipped classroom versus this traditional. So that is why I have suggested you to conduct a small study on the effectiveness of flipped classroom in your own subject, and I have suggested the way how to carry out a small experimental. So these are the findings of some of the research studies using the flipped classroom to enhance the English as foreign language learning, examining flipped learning in a sociology course, flipped classroom and mind mapping in teaching basic sciences, investigating the potential of the flipped classroom model, flipped classroom in organic chemistry has significant effect of a flipped classroom model in an introductory college mathematics course, and action research study from implementing the flipped classroom model in primary school history teaching and learning, impact of flipped teaching on student performance at school level in India in the context of different medium of instruction. So the goals of the flipped classroom model is to find an approach that would make it possible for teacher to move from sage to the guide, reduce the amount of time spent in class on lecturing, opening up class time for the use of learning, active learning, you see strategies, and focus more on understanding and application rather than remembering, while not sacrificing presentation of the factual base. Provide students with more control over their own learning, give students a great sense of their own responsibility, provide students with more opportunities to learn from their peers. So the steps which can be employed for the implementation of the flipped classroom. Firstly, establish, you see, clear learning outcomes and prepare a lecture plan. Okay, learning outcome is nothing but a sentence or statement which describes what the student will be able to do at the end of a unit of instruction. So figure out which lesson in particular you want to flip. So try to outline the key learning outcomes and develop a lesson plan. Then Second is record the video or develop the e-content. So you see, instead of teaching the lesson in person, you make a video and make sure it contains all the key elements you would mention in the classroom. So you can also develop e-content, self-learning material, paperwork, and give them for studying at home. Then next is that assure students access to videos and e-content, that you have to ensure that every student receives the material. So for this, what you can do is you can upload the material in the website of your institute, or you can provide them with a DVD, okay, or you can send to their email IDs. So you have to ensure that everybody gets the material. Then incorporate engaging learning activities to be done in class. You see, students listen to instruction, interaction, discussion with peers, problem, question-based, experiential, debate, lab work in the class time. And create multiple versions of each summative assessment for students to demonstrate their mastery of each learning outcome in a particular unit of study. So other strategies you see that can be used in class activities include, you see, active learning. So allow students to apply concepts in class where they can ask their friends, that is peers or the teachers, for feedback and clarification. Peer instruction, students can teach each other by explaining concepts or working on small problems. Collaborative learning activities could increase student engagement, enhance student understanding, promote collective intelligence. So today, after my session is over, Amandeep is going to interact with you on cooperative and collaborative learning strategies. Problem-based learning. So class time can be spent working on problems that can last for the duration. Discussions or debates can be carried out in the classroom. Now, as I told you that I would be giving you an illustration of developing self-learning material. So self-learning material is a method of providing individualized instruction in which student is active and proceeds at his or her own pace and is provided with immediate knowledge of results. So content is broken down into small unit. Each unit contains interactive language full of illustration examples. It also contains inbuilt questions followed by feedback. Then another unit, content, question, feedback, and at the end summary. And then at the end, we will give them the list of references or list of support material which is available on the Google or other websites. So self-learning material has got five major characteristics that make the learning of the student very relevant and satisfying on the part of the students. Firstly, self-explanatory. It means the self-learning materials are developed in such a manner that doesn't require any intermediary, that is the teacher, to explain the content. The content is written in simple language, interactive language, and small chunks to help the learner assimilate the content by reading and working through the instruction at home, because this is to be studied at home. So content is organized in a logical and integrated manner. So a teacher is built in into the text. That is why I said that when a teacher reads the material, he thinks that the teacher is talking to him and not simply is reading the text from a textbook. So language is interactive. I will give you the illustration. Self-learning material is self-contained. It means that the learners studying the material do not normally require additional material to learn the concept. So everything is included in it. All examples, videos, everything is there. Self-directed, because they are studying at home, so they don't have anybody to give them instruction. So every instruction is given to the student, how to proceed, how to answer, how to respond, and so on. As we all know, that important role of a teacher in the traditional classroom, that is face-to-face teaching, is to inspire the learner toward acquisition of concepts. So as such, teachers act as role models while learners generally try to emulate them. So teachers create interest, arouse their curiosity towards a subject. And these features are also included in self-learning material. Okay, you see, these can be provided through the integration of interactive mode of writing, some anecdotes, some real life example, illustration, some videos, feedback on self-assessment questions, etc. And it is self-evaluating. That is, inbuilt questions are there followed by feedback, so they can self-evaluate their own progress. Now, let me provide you one illustration of this one yes. Now you see, I have developed a computer assisted instruction package because it is being presented through technology. So that is why it is computer assisted instruction package. Or if it is in the form of print material, we call it as a self-learning module or e-content. Okay, if it is in the form of PDF. Now, for developing computer assisted instruction package, you need to know some of the softwares like Toolbook or Authorware. But these softwares are difficult to handle. So I have improvised on the PowerPoint. Okay, now in the PowerPoint presentation, if you you see, click mouse at any point, you will get the next screen. Or if you press any key of the keyboard, you get the next screen. But in this case, we have locked the mouse as well as keyboard. And in order to proceed further, we have created a button. So once the student presses the button, only then the next screen comes. Now the first screen contains the list of learning outcomes, that is what the learner will be able to do at the end of this particular topic. Okay, he will be able to understand the concept of average speed, know uniform and non-uniform velocity, understand the concept of acceleration, specific learning outcome, define average speed, calculate the average speed, identify from the given example whether an object is accelerated, state the SI unit of acceleration. So three buttons: home page, previous slide, next. Now we'll move to next. Now you see, in the traditional classroom, teacher you see assumes that his students are familiar with something, and then he tests those prerequisites by asking few questions. These things are also included in the self-learning material. Now here you will find one or two questions to know whether the student possesses the prerequisites or not. So there is a small question. If your car is moving at a speed of 60 km per hour in first 2 hours and 72 km per hour for the next 2 hours, it means your car is moving with, now there are four answers. Now you have to select the one, because this particular concept of uniform speed, etc., has been told in the previous you see. So yes, you see non-uniform speed. Now you are getting reinforcement. Well, your answer is correct. This icon, I have taken it from Google. So now the solution is also given here. Suppose I go to the previous page again. Suppose I answer this question. Your answer is not correct. Solution is again given. Now you can move to the next question. So all the directions are given here. Next. SI unit of velocity is, say answer is meter per second. So again, you got the appreciation. So the answer is given. Now you can move to the next question. Velocity is a vector quantity because it is determined by magnitude only, direction only, both magnitude and direction, neither magnitude nor direction. See, answer is magnitude and direction. So clapping. So your answer is correct. Velocity is a vector quantity because it is determined by both magnitude and direction. For example, this man is walking with a velocity of 2 km/h in west direction. Now you see how interesting it is. The student can study at his or her own pace. If you are a slow reader, you can read it slowly. After completing it, only then you will go to the next screen. Next. Now this is a small input, okay? And to catch the attention of the students, there are some inbuilt questions. The font color is somewhere changed, font type, font size is also changed, okay? On her way to Agra, Anjali travels by her car, which is moving at a speed of 50 km/h for first hour and 60 km/h for next hour. What is average speed of car? Well, average speed. You see, this is a kind of a language which the teacher generally use in the classroom. Again, this language is used for writing the module. This is a new term for you. Ye classroom mein bolte hai na, teacher. Now you will study about average speed. Now the question which comes in mind is that, is it necessary that an object covers equal distances in equal intervals of time? No, it is not possible. This is the interactive language. An object cannot cover equal distance in equal intervals of time. Ye textbook mein nahi hai language. Aapko simplify karni hai language. For example, while traveling in a car, it is not possible to keep car at a constant speed. So it is better to express speed in terms of average speed. So in case the student wants to go to the previous slide, he can move to the previous slide. Just see the previous slide. Okay. Now move to the next slide. When we travel in a vehicle, the speed of the vehicle changes from time to time depending on the condition existing on the road. This animation is taken from Google. In such a situation, the speed is calculated by the ratio of the total distance traveled by the vehicle to the total time taken for the journey, and this is called the average speed. Ab ye font size bada kar diya, color change kar diya. Next. If an object covers a distance s1 in time t1, distance s2 in time t2, and distance sn in time tn, then the average speed is given by. So ye humne ek box mein dal diya with the yellow highlighting. Okay, font size different ho gaya. Now here the formula is written here. Okay, thus when we say that the car travels at an average speed of 60 km/h, it doesn't mean that the car would be moving with the speed of 60 km/h throughout the journey. Next. Ab itna pada. Now you have one question. Now you because student knows the answer, knows the formula, he can solve it. Or in case he wants to again relook the formula, he can go to the previous slide. Now he can solve the problem and then he can identify the answer. Say answer is this one. So your answer is correct. Okay. Or in case the answer is wrong, say answer is this one. So this is not a good smiley. Okay. So it is not correct. So the solution is again given here. Now next. Now you can take an example of a car. Ye ugly input aa gayi. Ye bhi humne Google se liya hai. As in the case of uniform speed, car will have uniform velocity if it covers equal distances in equal intervals of time, no matter how small these time intervals may be, but in a specified direction in a straight line. So in this example, car will be, you see, moving, car will be having uniform velocity only if it travels 30 km/h in same direction. Next. But what will happen if the car changes its direction? Yes, change in direction will lead to change in the velocity of car. So this is interactive language. So let us think over how can we change the velocity of any body. There are two ways: either change the speed of the body or change the direction of the body by keeping speed constant. Mujhe lagta hai aap bhi apna recollect kijiye purana experience. Jab aap 5th class mein the to aapke teacher ne kaise padhaya tha. Now you see, this is a self learning material and this is to be given to student to study at home for use in the for as a e-content for flipped classroom. Next. Now you can take an example. Two athletes, Ram and Shyam, are running with a uniform speed of 5 m/s. Ram is running on a single track. This is single straight track. This is taken from Google. His two athletes, Ram and Shyam, are running with a uniform speed of 5 meter per second. Ram is running on a single track. This is single straight track. This is taken from Google. Okay. Shyam is moving on a circular track, again from Google. For a layman, both Ram and अब ये देखिए, आपने एनिमेशन डाली है, आप इसमें वीडियो अपेंड कर सकते हो. सो दैट विल बी वेरी मच इंटरेस्टिंग टू दी स्टूडेंट्स. क्लासरूम में ट्रेडिशनल वे में आप पढ़ाते हैं तो स्टूडेंट को इंटरेस्टिंग नहीं होता. सो वेयर एज इन केस ऑफ श्याम हु इज रनिंग अलोंग ए सर्कुलर ट्रैक, द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मोशन इज चेंजिंग एट एवरी इंस्टेंट एज सर्कल इज पॉलीगन विद इनफाइनाइट साइड्स एंड श्याम हैज टू चेंज इज डायरेक्शन एट एवरी इंस्टेंट. नेक्स्ट. तो अब आपने इसको हाईलाइट कर दिया, यूनिफॉर्म वेलोसिटी की जो डेफिनेशन लिख दी. ओके, नाउ नेक्स्ट. Let us take one more example. Car is moving on a road. What about its speed? What will it be uniform or not? Answer to the problem is velocity of car is not uniform because even if the speed of the car is constant, the car is changing its direction continuously. And this is the case of changing velocity. That is, velocity is variable or non-uniform velocity. Next. Now, again, one question pertaining to the previous content. Say the answer is non-uniform velocity. Your answer is correct. And another reinforcement. This problem has given rise to the new concept in the field of motion, and this is acceleration. So let us take an example of a car. It starts from rest, V0, 5 minutes second ke baad 10 minutes, after 10 second 20 minutes. Okay. So let's see. Then next. So in above example, car changes its velocity after every 5 seconds. If the velocity of the car increases, the body is said to be accelerating. Okay, ये आपने हाईलाइट कर दिया फॉर्मूला. Now next. Now you can try to answer this. What will be the acceleration of the body if it doesn't change its velocity with time? So well, in this situation, initial velocity of the body is this. So ये पूरा आपने कंप्यूटेशन कर दिया. Next. Next ये क्वेश्चन आ गया, ठीक है. Then say answer is this one. Your answer is not correct. So the solution is given here. Now next. When the term acceleration need not always mean the velocity of a moving body is always increasing. It can also decrease, remain the same, or become zero. You can take one more example to understand the relation between changing velocity and acceleration. So there is example. You can click here. Train starts from the rest and gains a speed of 600 meter per second. That is, it accelerates. After some time, it continues moving with uniform velocity. तो ये भी हमने गूगल से लिया. मतलब यू कैन टेक मेनी थिंग्स फ्रॉम द गूगल फॉर द एजुकेशनल पर्पज ओनली. नेक्स्ट. मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन ऑफ एक्सेलरेशन चेंजेस विद चेंजिंग वेलोसिटी ऑफ बॉडी. हियर यू कैन सी द लेंथ ऑफ एरो चेंजिंग विद चेंजिंग वेलोसिटी एंड एक्सेलरेशन. नेक्स्ट. सो एंड सेशन टेस्ट. अब आप सी आंसर इज दिस वन नॉट करेक्ट. मूव टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. Say non-uniform velocity. Say this is the answer. Your answer is correct. You got the award. Next, as a unit of acceleration is say meter per second square. So now, whatever is covered, you have given in a summary form. Okay. So next, thank you. Now you can go to the home page. So now, friends, the session is open for discussion. If you have any query or anything you want to add, you are welcome. You can raise your hand or you can unmute your mic and you can talk to us. Yes. Anything you, if you have got any doubt, please do conduct a small experiment about the effectiveness of flipped classroom on achievement of students. So do small action research and report the findings in some journal. Many good institutions are employing flipped classroom in their college. एफर्ट ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ द टीचर इज टू डेवलप ई कंटेंट। तो ई कंटेंट कैसे डेवलप करना है वो कल हमने एक सेशन रखा हुआ है, डॉक्टर मैथी दत्ता विल टॉक टू यू। और आज मैंने आपको पावर पॉइंट के ऊपर कैसे कंप्यूटर असिस्टेड इंस्ट्रक्शन बनाना है वो मैंने बताया, और मैंने आपको एक और बताया दैट वन मैसिव ओपन ऑनलाइन कोर्स इज अवेलेबल ऑन स्वयं प्लेटफॉर्म, एंड द टाइटल ऑफ दैट मैसिव ओपन ऑनलाइन कोर्स इज डेवलपमेंट ऑफ सेल्फ लर्निंग मटीरियल एंड दिस हैज बीन डेवलप्ड बाय मी। लास्ट डेट इज 28 फरवरी ऑफ दिस मंथ। यू कैन रजिस्टर इट, इट इज ए फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट कोर्स, इट इज एन EICT अप्रूव्ड FPP एंड इट इज ऑफ 2 क्रेडिट्स कोर्स एंड द सर्टिफिकेट विल बी इशूड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया।
Sir, could you please share the link of that course?
ओके
आई थिंक मेल इज ऑलरेडी गिवन।
मैं शेयर करता हूँ।
थैंक यू सर।
All participants kindly mark attendance. The link is in the chat box.
Could anyone from the organizer side, could you please share the day one link for the attendance?
Ma'am, that has been expired. Now you have to mark for day two. The attendance is marked.
Can be done.
The attendance have already been marked in the automatic software. Also, the email IDs are not given in that software. That's why I am taking.
Okay.
So good.
Thank you.
Excuse me, madam. Good morning, Sunil sir.
Good morning, sir.
Sir, so you were telling that some of the institutes are already practicing flipped classrooms, and what are the challenges there to practice flipped classroom teaching learning in the more institutes? I wish to know, sir, from you. So only few of the institutes I think they are practicing. So what are the challenges there or readiness? That is there
challenge
to,
is that to develop the material. The major challenge is to develop the material, because the teacher says that I have not, I don't have any time, because they have the time. So they have to, if they are not able to develop the e-content, the material which is available on internet can be sent to the students. मेरे स्टूडेंट ने वेब क्वेस्ट इंस्ट्रक्शन जो है उसकी इफेक्टिवनेस किया था। शी हैज प्रिपेयर्ड द लिस्ट ऑफ लिंक्स अवेलेबल ऑन यूट्यूब और गूगल एंड दोज आर प्रोवाइडेड टू द स्टूडेंट्स, दे हैव स्टडीड देमसेल्व्स।
या राइट सर, आई एक्सेप्ट यू फ्रॉम फैकल्टी साइड, एनीहाउ वी हैव टू डू दैट। So what should be the readiness or preparedness from the students, how they can be motivated?
They
or
manage, they have to manage time, they have to you have to tell them that after if you study at home, only then you will participate in problem solving exercises. So problem solving can be carried out in the classroom. They will shuru mein thodi si hesitation hogi, but later on they will be you see satisfying, they will be satisfied,
right sir?
बिकॉज क्लासरूम में बहुत बारी आप पूछोगे ना, बच्चा बच्चा सिर्फ अटेंडेंस मार्क करने के लिए आता है। इवन अभी भी हमने देखा है कि आउट ऑफ 200 पीपल ओनली 100 और 112 दे रिमेन प्रेजेंट, बट रेस्ट ऑफ देम दे ज्वाइन, दे लीव इन बिटवीन। तो ये होता है, वो कहते हैं हम कोई नई चीज तो बताओ ना, हम नई चीज अभी बता रहे हैं। इवन देन द पार्टिसिपेंट्स एटीट्यूड इज समटाइम न्यूट्रल।
Right sir, I accept you. Within the regular class hours, they are not interested to participate with the different reasons. How we expect them to prepare at the home as well as in the regular class hours to participate actively?
देखिए, आपने उनको you have to make the message clear that I will not study, I will not teach this topic in the class. I have given you the material. In case you have any doubt, you can come to the class for clarification. Or otherwise, you will be given assignment or quiz you will do in the class. So only those students will be able to complete the assignment or the task who have studied the material at home. वो आपको कहेंगे अगर वीडियो भी साथ में आपने दे दी है ना डेफिनेटली दे विल स्टडी. और आपको मैं बताऊं यूट्यूब के ऊपर दो मिनट से लेकर एक घंटे की इतनी सारी वीडियोस अवेलेबल हैं, हमें उनको आइडेंटिफाई करना है, उनके लिंक्स उनको प्रोवाइड करने हैं.
यस सर, आई एक्सेप्ट यू सर. एज द फैकल्टी वी हैव बीन दैट इज getting awareness on this flipped classroom teaching and the blended room, but I feel the students are not getting the clearly the methodology or the necessity of this kind of teaching learning approach. What are the ways to get this to be communicated to the teachers, students as well?
You are not the only thing you have to communicate to the student is that you will be given the material. You need not worry about the course content. You need not have to buy any textbook. Okay, you will be given the material, you will be given the video material, you study at home, aur jitni problems hain ya pichle saalon ke question papers hain they will be taken up in the classroom.
Yes, right sir. As an individual we do communicate with them, but as a policy how the faculty are being informed or communicated about the necessity of the blended learning and flipped classroom learning, but as a policy how it is getting to the student community, that's my question
sir. Aisa hai, yeah. In the classroom you are the king. Okay, you know which method is very efficient for a particular group of students. So please experiment upon this particular method by teaching only one or two topic, not all the topic. Once the students feel it very interesting, you can also give them an attitude scale. You can prepare some questionnaire to know their happiness over the use of this particular method. You can study their perceptions. I have shared the perceptions of one study, perception study. I have shared with you.
Yeah, yeah. So I agree with you, sir. But from the bodies like you, NITTR or some other agencies, I think there is no clear or standard instruction is given to the institutes to follow this new kind of teaching learning systems.
I think. मैंने अभी बोला दैट इन ए क्लासरूम टीचर इज द किंग. ही कैन यूज वैरायटी ऑफ अप्रोचेस टू मेक टीचिंग लर्निंग इफेक्टिव. सो नोबडी इज गोइंग टू गिव यू इंस्ट्रक्शन वेदर यू आर यूजिंग ओनली द कन्वेंशनल मोड ऑफ टीचिंग, यू गो ऑन यूजिंग इट. बट इन केस यू वांट योर स्टूडेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड मोर, यू कैन एम्प्लॉय गुड टेक्निक्स. इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर Mrs. Amandeep Gaur is going to share with you the collaborative and cooperative learning strategies. So these will help the student learn better.
Sir, right, sir. I agree with you. As the agencies like you, you are taking up so many this FDPs like that for the faculties. So it means that as a whole, the system is expecting to be follow these kind of new things mostly. But when I asked you, you are telling that as an individual you have to carry out your own style of teaching like that.
Or secondly, that is why we are making the teachers aware. You see, through this course, we are making the teachers aware about the use of flipped classroom and blended mode of learning. And I must tell you that our institute is conducting this present course as a fourth course in this year, and large number of courses have been. Conducted by different organization in this country through Atal, you can say, site.
Yeah. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you. Okay. Thank you very much.
So, if we have no more questions, so we break for 2 minutes, and I think Dr. Mrs. Amandeep Gaur might have, she has joined. So now the session is over to Mrs. Amandeep Gaur, please.